Whenever I try to predict what kind of video is going to come next, I always get surprised by getting led in a totally different direction or just to something that I didn't even know of before. So here we're going to talk about the Archangelsk, or Archangel area of Northern European Russia. Now this area is unbelievable because it's been a medieval chief seaport way before St. Petersburg, so you know it had been known for a long time, and it's right at the top, like by the North Pole. So if this was a chief seaport, then there must have been ships around that polar region of the ocean, and there must be a lot of things that we don't know about, because how else could it be a chief seaport in the middle of an ocean that not many other civilizations are at? There must have been a lot. And this place is named after Archangel Michael, who destroyed the devil, and they believe this was the area that that battle happened in, which also makes me kind of confused and interested about what's up north and, you know, who was the Michael, who was the devil, and what battle may have taken place in this area, because it seems to be a very holy place. And when talking and theorizing about places in this part of our northern world, it's impossible to not talk about the Mercator map. And John Levy did a nice off-topic about this. A lot of people have talked about this. There's so many different things to go into. Friesland, the magnetic center, Mount Meru, everything. But here today, I just want to kind of refer to it as being the cause of this being an important seaport. And so in order for it to be a very important seaport, there must have been some life and some continents up north. It couldn't have just been ice, and they couldn't have been dealing with polar bears and penguins. There must have been something totally different. And the spiritual aspect of it and the resonators on top of all the churches kind of leads towards something interesting. And especially with the Battle of the Archangel, you know, there could have been winged beings up here. There's so many different stories of people, explorers that have gone up to this area and come back with different stories or written stories, and who knows whether it's hollow or keeps going. That's a totally different topic too. But here we're going to look. This is where the Archangelsk area is, and it is in a very nice spot. So if you want to check it out, there's all kinds of different Google markings around that I've spotted, things that look like old civilizations, old foundations. But this island is very interesting because this island is out here, these two little islands, and they have amazing churches on them and forts. Like that big one I showed right at the very beginning, I believe is on that main island. So here are four churches, one of which is a star fort, and the other ones are pretty much wooden smaller ones. But there does appear to be some life in this area. Like there seems to be like a little town and whatnot. I'm sure this has definitely become a bit of a tourist attraction now. But as far as inhabiting it in the back in the day, like I can't imagine. You know, they felt the need. There's not many other buildings, but they felt a need to always have a church, which blows my mind kind of, and makes me really think that there is an essential purpose to these buildings. Because a lot of people, you know, nowadays I do my art, I can pray in my house, in my bedroom. It doesn't really have to be. But maybe there's something that makes them have to build these. As I saw in one thing that talked about there being no church for like 6 kilometers, so they had to build one. And it's just, the thinking behind that is like, you know, why not build like a farm or a power or something like a little more important? But maybe our perceptions modernly of what is important and what is a necessity are very different from the people back then. Like this may have been a necessity. The gold on their tops may have done something that we can't fathom. They may have gone into these areas and prayed with their local friends and achieved states of consciousness that we can't understand. So there had to have been, because it just doesn't make sense. If you need a sacred space, the whole world is kind of a sacred space, I believe, but there had to have been a purpose for their desire and need to always construct these, because they're all over the place. And this Archangelsk area is definitely, I've been here for a long time. You can just feel it just by looking at it. It looks like there's so many layouts all over the place, and it's probably on to this massive layout that's been here since medieval times and way before. You know, if the beings inhabited the North Pole and those continents are populated, then there's no telling who was here at one point and what the life was like. And it was funny because on the Wikipedia page, it showed the population and the censuses over the years going down. And you know, these places are not what they used to be. They used to be just something very important. And the receptors on the top have got to be purposeful. They're colored certain times. They're gold. The gold is really something special. And you know, what if Mount Meru, like they believe it was a gold mountain. What if all those kind of, you know, that was the trade that came from over there, the gold that we know of. And I mean, there's gold all over the place, and that could have been, you know, buried. Like what if over time that was a very ancient civilization that had gold all over the place, and then, you know, land, dirt, dust, dirt, of earthquakes, natural erosion, everything kind of just comes on top of it, you know, like it's doing with all these other ancient buildings. It just piles on top of these different things. But the gold has got to be important, and the resonators at the top have got to somehow connect to consciousness. And there has to be like a difference between the praying then and the praying now, I believe. And if they did have substances and entheogens, then they could have had really serious experiences and energetic, vibrational healing zones, and you know, something different. They must have been so important and allowed them to maybe even connect with different things and contact and communicate with different beings of the ether, or different ancient relatives, different distant relatives. Maybe they had the connection to the next world or the nether realms or the other dimensions that we see or experience in those or shamans experience. You know, maybe these buildings gave access to them, so they had to build them. It was an important part of their life. You know, they could do the farming, they could do the other stuff, but they had to build these things. And you know, how old are these really? And the stories that were told from the Bible, like are we hearing everything? Is there something that's been left out and been omitted over time that kind of makes it all make a little more sense and a little more relatable? And you know, modern man just cannot grasp these ancient mindsets because their world is just so different. It's impossible to plant ourselves what we know back then. They were totally different. Their worlds were totally different. They needed their nature, their gods, their divinity. They were one with it. And there's a lot that we have to discover. And places like this really lead to some amazing things. I have a feeling exploring in Google Earth the Russian rivers and all the areas by the rivers, really in every part of the world, explore the areas by the rivers, because that's where it seems like these star forts were built and these civilizations were built. And the lines that exist all over the place, it's through all the woods, there's all these points, what's seemingly pointless lines. And look at that, totally made out of wood. Even the resonator's made out of wood. Maybe it had gold on it at one point, but maybe not. Maybe just that pattern, the flower of life pattern, is what creates it and what creates the harmony. Maybe keeps the weather away. Maybe the lightning, maybe the ether, maybe an ancient substance that we had no idea about. And you know, this looks like medieval Rome, Piranesi, up in northern Russia. So I seriously believe that these things are all over the place up north. Those continents that Mercator drew in his map were done there for a reason. And that, for some reason, that map survived, but all the other ones, probably based on that land, didn't. And the Friesland mystery, you know, on the 57th latitude, there, that has to be discovered. We need some sailors to go out there and try to figure out what's there and see if they get blocked or something. But you know, in northern Russia, in this area, it was not too cold back in the day. There was something that was different. That is unbelievable, this palace. And these people, if they were just kind of uneducated and unskilled, would not be making these amazing things. So here are just some odd marks. Looks like a potential star fort. There's a lot of different zones, and it's so easy they can just crush it. But the lines kind of stay there because things don't really grow on those spots. So they're all over the place. We need to figure it out. This is Archangelsk. I recommend everybody explore it. If anyone's from there, definitely chime in. Let us know a little bit. And these are just all theories. Again, you know, I saw this place. It made me think a lot of different things. And so I wanted to share it with you all. Get it out just quick before I dig really deeper into it. Maybe I'll do more on this in time. But if you have any input, share it. And if there's any connection here to Tartaria or anything else anyone else has been looking up and researching, then definitely let us know. Let's piece it all together, all of us. And this is Human Being, a 5-foot drawing I did of my mom, based on my mom, and split into the golden ratio, so I only got to the upper half. But the golden ratio, I feel, is very important, as it plays a role in nature, it definitely played a role in construction, and the ancient powers definitely took advantage of the power of it. And a lot of people talk about the kingdom of heaven inside you, and I do believe that, and maybe the kingdom of heaven is kind of a description of our ancient world, our ancient ancestors, who were making kingdoms all over the place. And as far as the energy is concerned about radiating, you know, this is a lotus being inside the flowering of life, another kind of golden ratio-esque pattern, an ancient symbol. And I wonder if, you know, people were harmonizing, if they were able to naturally do this, or if they had any kind of sacred mushroom or tea or any kind of herb that helped them. But the resonating power of the human and their energy, and I think that they, you know, all the stuff that we kind of consider new agey now might have been real back then. And like, you know, maybe we've lost it. Maybe our sensors, our human receptors have lost that ability to it. And maybe these things, like maybe spirituality was a part of life, like drinking or eating. You know, if you do it healthily and you do it a certain way and really meticulously, like working out, it leads to longevity, increased healing, increased mental capacity, increased strength. increased everything. And you know, we would be led towards realizations like that nowadays, sadly. But the powers that be just kind of don't want us to realize our true potential, and it's really depressing. And looking back into the past, we can really imagine our true potential, because we were capable of creating this, unless there were giants and stuff, which there could have been, and other beings and whatnot. No aliens. I forget about all that nonsense. All the magic is right here, further on in our gigantic sphere of our world. And the magic is inside each of us. And we have to pull it back, because we can't let us forget. We can't let humanity forget what it was capable of. And so keep realizing, keep theorizing, and keep loving everything. Bless you all.